Test. Check. Okay. I'm gonna go with easy mode. Dang it, I need to change my battery on my e-cig.
Get a move on, Ollie boy!
Slow down, Mr. Drippy.
But Ding Dong Dell's just on the way.
Huh?
Hmm? Oh.
Huh? What do we do?
Shall we?
Huh? Hey, wait for me! So this is your world.
That's right. A whole nother world. Beautiful, innit?
Why, good morning, Oliver. Your groceries are over there, honey.
Thanks.
Oh, I almost forgot. Did Philip find you? He said he had something to show you, dear.
Really? So he finally finished it, huh? Do you know where he is right now?
He just stepped out with some deliveries for me. I doubt he'll have gotten far.
Thanks, Miss Layla.
Oh, say hi to your mother for me.
Sure thing, Miss Layla.
Hey, Ollie. Over here. Good thing you found me. Guess what? She's finally ready.
So what Miss Layla said? Is it really what I think it is?
What else would it be, dum-dum?
Boy, you are something else, Phil. So what do we do now?
What else? We take her for a spin. Tonight.
What? Tonight? But I can't. I mean, I need to ask my mom.
Sure. You go ask your ma. And then when do we do it, huh? Tomorrow? Next year?
Well, I... No, but... Okay, we'll do it tonight. But we'll have to be real quiet.
Sure we will. Okay, tonight in my garage. Be there or be square.
Sure.
So, this is the child who will save the world.
Or so says the crystal ball, your radiance.
The dark djinn's power alone will not suffice.
I fear not.
What is the child's name?
Oliver, your radiance.
Oliver?
Hey, Mom. I got the groceries.
Thanks, sweetie. Just pop them on the table, will you?
Say, Mom.
Did you say something, sweetie?
You're
kinda busy tomorrow, huh?
Well, now that you mention it, I do have to practice for my concert in the morning.
Oh yeah? So, you'll be in bed kinda early, huh?
Hmm? Yes, I suppose I will.
Oh, you will, huh?
Will you stop being so mysterious and eat your breakfast? You'll be late for school. Mm. And chew before you swallow.
Thanks for breakfast, Mom. See you later, Mom.
Bye, sweetie. You be good now.
I will.
What are you looking at? What is it with that kid? What kept you, Slowpoke?
Sorry, my mom just wouldn't go to bed. So, is it finished?
Sure is. The last bearing's in, and she's primed for action. Wanna see?
Do I ever?
All right. Here goes nothing.
Okay.
Wow!
Oh, is this neat, Phil? This is so, so neat!
You betcha.
It's so neat!
The new Coupe Deluxe ain't got nothing on us, Ollie.
It's not even close.
You ready to hit the road, kiddo?
Yeah!
Oh, hey. I'm doing good. Playing some Ni No Kuni. It's like a Studio Ghibli game.
The coast is clear. I better go tell Phil.
Don't go!
What? Huh?
It's bad. Please, Oliver, don't go.
Huh? Who are you? How do you know my name?
Ollie! What's taking you so long?
I'm sorry, Phil. Someone saw me.
Oh, man. Who was it?
That girl of...
What are you talking about? There's nobody there.
Huh. That's weird. She was right there. A girl.
A girl, huh?
Mm-hmm.
I bet it was that dumb, scary Mary. Oh no, couldn't be. She's not allowed out. You must be going screwy or something. Anyway, come on.
Okay.
Oliver. The boy who will save the world. But unfortunately for him, his light is yet a mere candle in the blackness.
Indeed. He may be the child the prophecies speak of, but he is a child nonetheless.
Yet these humans can be disturbingly powerful. Did the other's darkness not engulf the land entirely? Might this one not prove equally tenacious?
What would you have me do, your radiance?
Such saplings must not be suffered to grow.
Very well, your radiance.
He who would save this doomed world must die.
Sweetie? Where are you? Oliver? Oliver?
You're kind of busy tomorrow, huh?
Well, now that you mention it, I do have to practice for my concert in the morning.
Oh, yeah? So, you'll be in bed kind of early, huh?
Oliver. Oliver.
Ni No Kuni is the name of the game. Wrath of the White Witch. It was made a few years back, but it finally came to PC. Yeah, that part was a bit harsh, telling him to die. The animation's really good, though. Oh no.
Wake up. Mom?
Oh, sweetie, I'm so glad you're okay.
I'm sorry, Mom.
I'm sorry. I swear, if I'd known, I never would have.
Don't be silly, Phil. What about your car?
That hunk of junk. I can make another one in no time.
Well, I think you two have had quite enough excitement for one time.
Yes, ma'am. Ja.
Are you okay, Phil?
Must have twisted my ankle back there.
Whatever will you children get up to next?
Huh? Allie!
Allie?
Are you okay?
Mom? What's wrong?
Oh my.
Mom?
She always did have a weak heart.
Mom?
Oh dear.
I'll fetch the doctor.
Mom!
Oliver, sweetie. Oh, sweetie.
Mom!
You'll be okay. I know you will. Be good now. For me.
Mom? Mom?
Sentimental fool. Sacrificing herself to save her child.
And yet, thanks to her, the boy lives.
Of course. But shorn of his mother's love, to whom can he now turn for guidance? And soon he will come to our world, where our powers are strongest.
Very good, your radiance.
Let us see how this story unfolds. I'm sure the ending will be engaging.
Oliver, honey, I brought you some apple pie. I'll just leave it here for you, okay, dearie? Just have to wait until dinner, Timmy told her. Oh, it's so sad. He's been in there 3 whole days now.
Sammy starts her new job today, but she's asked someone very special to take care of you. Mommy spent a long time making him. I'm sure he'll look after you very well. Be good while Mommy's away, okay?
Mommy!
Is something wrong, sweetie?
Just come back soon, okay?
Of course, sweetie. We'll always be together, Oliver. Always. Always.
Mommy, come back. Please.
Lifted, is it? Tiny! I'm free! Free!
Huh? What just happened?
You just witnessed the rebirth of Drippy, Lord High, Lord of the Fairies.
Who?
What, are you deaf or something? Drippy, Lord High, Lord of the Fairies, I said, didn't I?
Drippy?
That's right, and I'm sick to the teeth of you a snivelling and moaning. A proper crybaby bunting you are. 3 days, man. I mean, I've been sad before, but crying for 3 whole days? I'm surprised there's a drop of water left in you. You're a big boy, man. 3 days is, well, it's unheard of.
What?
Oh, dear, a bit flummoxed, are we? Bit lost for words. Not to worry, man. I got all the answers. Oh, but prepare yourself. Explaining all this is gonna take a while. Ready?
Uh-huh.
Tidy. I like your style. Very honest, innit? Stay that way, okay? Take you far, it will. On with the show!
Okay.
See, it's like this, see? What it is there's more worlds out there than this one by here. There's what you might call parallel worlds, see? They're like worlds along by the side of your one. And one of those worlds is my world. That's right, a whole nother world.
Another world?
That's quick you are. And I, that is the Lord High Lord of the Fairies, the reason I'm by her in this world of yours, well, it's because there's a proper bad apple trying to upset the peace of both our worlds, see? Shada, the Dark Djinn, his name is. And what he did was, he took over people's hearts and spread war and ruin all over our world. Tried to stand up to him, I did. And he turned me into a flipping doll and kicked me out of our world and into yours, the rotter.
Uh-huh.
And then you went and cried all over me and poof, the curse was lifted, just like that. Which makes me think you must be the one we fairies call the pure-hearted one. The one the legends say will save our world. Just goes to show you can't judge a book by its cover, eh? So, anyway, that means I better get you over to our world and have you get rid of Shaddaa for us. All right with you?
Me? But how can I?
Don't fret, man. It's a big responsibility, I know, but you'll be all right. Especially with me to help you.
But I...
Oh, want me to ask properly, do you? Fair dues.
What?
Oh, pure-hearted one, will you please come and save our world?
No.
Sorry, I must have misheard you. What did you say? Go on, once more, but louder.
I won't do it. I mean, I can't do it.
This is why they say never work with children. I ask nicely, and you give me a hearty, yes, sir. That's how this works, see? Gee whiz, that would be swell, you say. It's just how these things are done. It's tradition. How am I supposed to work with this? It's like he's never read a story in his life.
But I don't know anything about your world. And I just can't right now.
What, because your mom dropped dead?
Yeah.
You got a photo of her? Hurry up, will you? I haven't got all day.
Okay.
Let's see now. Blimey. It can't be. But then it can't be a coincidence, neither.
What is it?
The great sage Alicia. Then we might just be able to save you, ma'am.
Huh? What are you talking about?
You ready for another yearfall?
Yeah.
The souls of people in your world and my world are connected, which means people from over by you have another version of themselves over by there, called a soulmate, see?
and people with soulmates can even look like each other. Now, your mom, well, she shared a soul with the great sage Alicia. A proper talent she was.
Huh? So my mom was a sage? But how does that help us save her?
Well, Alicia tried to take on the Dark Djinn, but his power was too much for her, and he trapped her in this dark jewel called the Soul Snare. When that happened, then the link between hers and your mom's souls would have been cut off. But if you could free Alicia, it just might fix the link. And who knows, it might even bring your mom back.
Is that really true?
I can't be sure now, but it's possible, yeah.
Wait. How do you know all this, Mr. Dribby? You've been a doll this whole time.
Ah, now there's clever of you. Good question, lad. It's like this, see? I'm not the only fairy. Even though I was stuck by you, my buddies were keeping me abreast of all the goings-on over there. How? I suppose it's what you might call telepathy. And that's not all. I was sending my lordly orders back over there, too. Having them spy on Shaddaa and that, you know, tidy, huh? Hmm? What is it?
I'll do it. I'll come to your world. I'll come with you and save my mom.
Oh, that's marvelous! You might be doing it for all the wrong reasons, but if it saves our world, I won't look a gift horse in the mouth. Tidy, we better get going then. Chop, chop.
Okay. But how do we get to your world?
Oh, curious, are we? All right, I'll tell you. First thing we need is a drop of magic. Go and have a dig around in the fireplace. There's something hidden there so nosy parkers won't find it.
But why would anybody hide something in there?
That's for me to know and you to find out. Look lively.
What could be hidden in a place like this?
A mighty spell book!
Huh? A book? But it would burn in there.
Not this book. The wizard's companion laughs in the face of fire. Wouldn't be much of a spell book if it didn't, now, would it?
Really?
Aha! Gotcha!
This is a spell book?
That there is the wizard's companion, the fount of all wizarding knowledge.
The wizard's companion.
Yay, I obtained the wizard's companion. Oh, I gotta choose the name. I'll just write his name. How do you do?
Right, magic in our way over to my world, is it? Now let's see.
What is it?
You got a wand somewhere by here? We can't go casting spells without a wand now, can we?
A wand? Why would we have a wand?
Oh, that's a pain. Ah, well, can't be helped. We just have to look for one outside.
Huh? We won't find one out there either.
Don't nitpick, crybaby Bunting.
Bunting? My name is Oliver. Oliver.
Ah, so the crybaby bit was right, at least was it.
Find a stick. Thank you. Flagging? What does flagging mean?
You're the little girl I met before, huh?
Mm-hmm. We met before.
So, how do you know who I am?
I'm really, really sorry, Oliver.
Huh?
Your mummy. I'm sorry. I couldn't save her.
Huh? I don't... Why would you be sorry for
that? Oh, yeah, I'm getting kind of tired.
I wanted to
save
her.
I was up early.
I really did.
Huh?
I didn't get much sleep last night either.
Where are you... going? Hey, where did you go?
Ollie boy, why are you talking to thin air?
Mr. Drippy, she disappeared again.
Huh? Who did?
That strange girl. That's the second time she tried to talk to me.
What's that? A girl? Where? You're right about strange. I can't see her any flipping where.
Well, how could you?
She
disappeared.
I know.
Into thin air.
Well,
just
anyway,
couldn't fall asleep.
There's something I want to ask you.
There is?
Then my cat was outside all night, and...
Sure, go ahead.
Do you mind it?
I woke up every so often, and then I heard her meowing outside and had to go let her in.
Crikey, that's cold. Who do you mean, he says? Why not stab me in the heart while you're at it? I mean me. I wanted to know if it was all right me joining you on your adventures. Or if you were maybe wanting to trade me in for a younger, prettier model. But it looks like I got my answer, huh? Well, so you know, if you don't have faith in people, you'll never see their true worth. And what's more?
Look at this.
Huh?
It was on the ground, right where that girl was standing.
Chuck it here, then. Ta. Well, I'll be a monkey's uncle. It's a wand.
You mean it?
No, not usually, but when I let her out late at night, sometimes she stays out. And then I go to bed and forget about her. I don't forget about her, I go looking for her and I don't find her. And then she comes back later and meows at the window.
But for our current purposes, it's a beauty.
Neato. What a stroke of luck.
Luckier than you know, Ollie boy. Dude, I never thought we'd actually find one.
Do you think maybe that girl brought it here for me?
Got an old stick.
Right, now we need a place to cast our spell. To cast Gateway, you need somewhere proper massive. You need space to give it oomph, see?
Do we really need that much oomph?
Yeah, what kind of question is that? Magic is special, innit? It's sacred, right? You have to cast spells in the best environment possible. You really are new to this, aren't you? This is beginner stuff we're talking about here.
Oh, sorry.
Now, take me somewhere with plenty of space. It's got to be somewhere around by here.
The town square, I guess.
Town square.
Do you really think we should be doing this here?
No worries, man. Normal people can't see magic, see? Go on, Ollie boy. Cast Gateway.
Tectonic plates. What better way to spend a Saturday night?
Bunting, crybaby Bunting!
For the last time, it's Oliver!
Hey, it's not bad work for a crybaby, this.
Oh.
Just wondering if this game is gonna, like, speed up at some point, or if it's gonna be constant story with little interaction. Then I will get tired. It's kind of like watching an anime, though, but you do interact.
So this is your world.
Ah, home at last! But there's a tidy way to go yet.
Hey, Mr. Drippy, that was pretty neat just now, huh?
Oh, that herd of elk! Enjoy your first encounter with the majestic wildlife of our mysterious world, did you?
Uh-huh. Huh? Jeepers.
Oh, knickers! Where did he spring from?
Huh? Ah!
Jeepers.
What did he do?
He's not like the big softies just now. He's itching for a fight. Proper savage.
Let's run away.
No, use that stick you got by there. Give him a whacking and send him packing.
Huh? Ah!
Look lively. He's making his move.
Watch this.
Gonna attack that poor thing. Rough. Bob's your uncle. Bad dog.
Thank you. nice one, aren't you, mate?
Jeepers creepers.
Oh yeah, I forgot to mention. Our world is absolutely riddled with beasties. But keep that up and you'll have nothing to worry about. Right, let's get a move on, shall we?
Sure, Mr. Drippy. But where are we going?
Well, first off, we need to get you a wand.
But I already have a wand.
You're having a laugh, aren't you? That thing's about as magical as a flipping cabbage. You might just squeeze a gateway spell out of it, but you can forget about anything more than that. Honestly, I wish you'd think before you open your mouth.
Oh, sorry.
No, I told you Ding Dong Dell was just over by yonder, didn't I? Well, if we're very lucky, we might find a wand with a bit more oomph down by there.
So, are wands really so hard to find here?
Well, time was you couldn't move for the flipping things. But since Shaddaa showed up, magic's taken a real nosedive. He banned people from using it, see? Cursed anyone who tried to. He scared them all so much they gave it up.
So, he's pretty scary, huh?
Well, he turned me into a flipping doll, didn't he? Just saying his name's enough to make most folks brick it. Still, I'd rather be a doll than have him go poking round in my heart. No one wants to be broken-hearted.
Broken-hearted? Like, sad?
Worse than that. Much worse. It's when he steals a piece of a person's heart. Poor beggars don't know whether they're alive or dead. That's no way to live, man.
So that's why they're all so scared of him, huh? We can't let him go on doing this.
Well, it's not a matter of letting him, is it? It's not like people flipping enjoy it. That's why I brought you here, innit? You might just be able to stop him, see?
You really think I can?
Course you can! You are the pure-hearted one! And the legends say that the pure-hearted one will drive away the darkness. We'll teach you a few tasty spells and you'll be ready to face him in no time. Sound good to you?
Okay, I'll do it. I'll learn magic.
Course you will, and that's why we need to find you a better wand.
All right, let's head for Ding Dong Dell.
Tidy.
Thank you.
looks to me like a classic case of brokenheartedness.
Brokenheartedness? You mean that thing you were talking about before?
That's right. The brokenhearted are people who've had part of their hearts stolen. Poor souls just aren't themselves. Go all weird and useless, they do.
So his heart was broken by...
Keep up, will you? Shadar, innit? If anyone tries to stand up to him or does anything he doesn't like, he breaks their hearts into pieces so they can't put up a fight.
Jeepers. But if he stays that way, we can't get into Ding Dong Dell.
Perhaps I'll buy myself a new dress.
To be an adventurer. What's that?
Let's go! Watch this!
Yeah.
do this! Let's do it!
I didn't realize I could run around. Deep dark wood. I was wondering about that. Yeah, I've reached the first save point. First real save point. I'm gonna take a break now. I will be back.